Decker, we're live, man. So as long as we don't have any issues, we're live and ready to go. First of all, I want to thank anybody watching this now or into the future. We really appreciate you. I'm Pat with Local Stash. It's an online collection database of downtown maps of over 700 of what we consider the coolest rural resort towns in America. And so if you get a chance, go to localstash.com, grab your state's Local Stash card, and you'll be able to use it in a lot of places. Obviously, we think Trinidad, Colorado is one of those coolest rural resort towns. And so some of the interviews we're doing right now are the movers and shakers, the boots on the ground, the people that are doing that. Jason Decker's with me today, and Jason's a co-owner of the Well Hotel and Tap Room. He's also a member of the Trinidad Art Fest, which is what we're going to be talking about mostly today. And he's a one of the founding members, or one of the early members, charter members of the Trinidad Lodging Tax Advisory Board. Think of that as what a tourism board would do, but with a little more guidance and a little more direction, and I would like to say a little more advocacy, kind of going forward. Jason, let me just be real kind of personal here real quick. Jason and his partner Keely Williams are the exact kind of people you want to move into your town. You just hope they're, you know, they come here. They bring an energy and quality to everything both of them do. And if you're around them for a little bit, you find out they really care about their community. They act as if they were born here. They act as if they're here. So I'm personally really glad both of them are here. Welcome, Jason. Really appreciate you making the time to be here and do some sharing.
Yeah, thank you, Pat. Thanks for having us. Really excited to talk about Arts Fest. And thank you for all your support and all that you do in Trinidad as well.
When you love a place, it's kind of easy. So I want to do past, present, and kind of future, okay? So past, we'll talk about the past of the first annual Art Fest, because this is the second one. And you don't get a second one unless the first one was pretty good. So we know we're building on a good foundation. But I wanted you to talk a little bit about where you were before here, okay? A little bit of finding Trinidad, the real investment you made in bringing a great music venue and beer venue and community center kind of venue in the Well Hotel and Tap Room. And so kind of tell me a little bit about your journey to Trinidad, and then we'll get on to the other stuff.
Yeah, well, I'm a career digital marketer. I work for some big firms in a variety of different roles, including tourism, and actually came to Colorado for a job where the entire role was marketing for small rural mountain towns in Colorado and in the hospitality and tourism industry. So that was kind of where I really got to explore a lot of Colorado and traveled around in a lot of the places and got to see where my clients were and just really fell in love with the smaller parts of Colorado that might not be international brands, but are still incredible, you know, communities and are beautiful and have so much art and culture and interesting people and things to do. And yeah, from there, I brought my wife, Keely. I got her to move to Colorado. We were in New Orleans at the time, where she had been for 15 years. And until she met me, she didn't think she was going to be leaving. But I loved Colorado so much. And New Orleans is an amazing place. But I wanted to be back in the mountains. I wanted to be back in Colorado. I just love the people. And there's just so many different incredible places in Colorado to go to. It's endless. There's always more to explore here. And we just wanted to get back. And Keely is just an absolute rock star mastermind, architect and real estate developer. And really her specialty is rehabilitating historic buildings. So Keely was actually in architecture school at Tulane in New Orleans when Hurricane Katrina happened. And while she was in school, she literally with her bare hands helped rebuild New Orleans when Katrina happened. So she's got more experience than most people on earth about rehabilitating historic buildings, because there's so many of them in New Orleans. And you know, that's really what she's made her career and her passion about. So when we moved here to Colorado, we were looking for, you know, a mountain town to do a project in. Keely had done a hotel and bar in New Orleans, and so very successful. It's still going today. And we wanted to do something like that here. And we looked and we ran around to different places, and they weren't the right vibe. We didn't know. And then she went down, I believe it was the day before Halloween, to Trinidad, and took a look at what at the time was a Hallmark building. And this is during 2020, where things were pretty sleepy everywhere, and especially down in Trinidad. And, you know, it's pretty much lockdown mode. There's not a lot of people on the street, but she's like, you got to see this building. It's incredible. It's got so much history. And she brought me back down the next day, and we said, yep, that's the one, and put in an offer. And next thing you know, Zoom a couple of days later. And yeah, now the hotel and music venue and restaurant are open at the Well. And we are working on completing the hotel, which should be open later this year.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And again, yeah, Keely is, first of all, she's a sweetheart, but also she's formidable, you know, and she's doing all kinds of great stuff here. So let's jump into the art fest. Okay. And I'm just going to let you just go on this for a little while. Okay. If you want to. So we've got plenty of time. Mickey and I, my sweetie and I, were able to go to last year. And I would be remiss to not say you have a great team of folks. Certainly Lee Lopez is another sweet and formidable woman. Okay. And she's also a mover and a shaker. So I know that so she helped put kind of was a spearhead on it last year. Mickey and I got a chance to go to it. It was outstanding. The venue we'll talk about here in a little bit. Outstanding in town. You get that great vibe, but it went off really well. Actually, let me show some stuff with regards to that. I'm going to show something real quick. So let me do this. And I'll pick this. Let me pick the right one if I can. Come on. Well, you can see the venue right here, okay? That's part of Trinidad around there, but you can see kind of the venue right here, right downtown, right on Commercial Street. Music, all that sort of stuff is awesome. I'm going to show the team real quick. There's a big team behind this doing amazing things. And so we'll get back to just you and I. But I do know that it was outstanding, and you usually don't get a second bite at the apple unless the first bite was really good. So tell me a little bit about the 2023 second annual Trinidad Art Fest, because it's more than art.
Yeah, so I joined the board this year, and just because it's such an event, and I'm passionate about art and music. It's a big part of Trinidad. It's just a big part of my life. But we have a rock star team. I mean, and everyone on the team is also an artist in their own regard. So Lee Lopez is got some incredible art at Fisher's Peak Outfitters, as well as we were fortunate enough to get her to put some up at the Well. Crystal Russell, also, you know, incredible musician, with the Trinidad Tea Company, and just a creator. And then Jason, JC Pico, some of the finest musicians in Trinidad who always seem to have another project going on, and they play every kind of music under the sun. And also they do the lighting and sound at Main Street Dive. And I mean, it's world-class stuff. So to be able to put on an event like this, you got to have a great team. And we certainly have one. So last year, in the first year, there was over 600 attendees that came there. And these were local people. There was actually a big tour bus that came down from Colorado Springs. People were coming from as far as Florida to come down to Trinidad to go to this art fest. And there was an incredible variety of local artists, people from all over the country. There was metalworking, there was leather, all sorts of varieties of different painting and photography. There was a broom maker, just all sorts of really incredible stuff going on. A little bit of something for everyone. I know I went down and got some art that's hanging up at the Well it actually turned out to be a local artist as well. So there's a really great combination of local artists really kind of showing off what they got, as well as, you know, people that are hearing about Trinidad, and they're coming from, we see a lot of people that are coming from out of state, and it's really turned into, you know, a really big event for tourism. And due to the great success of last year, that we added on a second day. It was just kind of a no-brainer to now it's going to be on July 15th and 16th. It's a Saturday and Sunday, 10 to 6 on July 15th, the Saturday, and Sunday, 10 to 4, July 16th.
Yeah, when everything you said is so spot on and just true, because Trinidad has real history here. So when you come to Trinidad, you're going to see art just walking around the streets. Mm-hmm. The buildings are art. The streets mm-hmm. are art. The backdrops are art. And so you see that. Then you find out, if you stick here a little bit, you find out, and you'll stick here a little bit, you'll come in maybe the 14th, stay the 15th, stay the night of the 15th, stay the 16th. You're going to find out that we have, and I'm just going to say this because I believe it, we have the highest concentration of quality music per capita of any place in the country. You can come here and you can see four different quality groups on a night, you know, and you're within walking distance to all of them because we have one of the most walkable towns in the area. So what I really love is the local artists there. But what Trinidad has done for the last, let's say, almost decade, and it's starting to come to fruition right now, is really an investment in the art, the creative class economy, that I call it, in that we not only have the space to create, we have the commons there, but we have some incredible galleries that have popped up that if you like art and you like music and you like the cool, and that's, look at Articade that we have, Art Cars. I mean, it's just amazing what we have. So tell me a little bit about, because it's more than art. So I want you to tell a little bit more about maybe the music side of it. And then we're going to make a call out, because there's still time, I believe, for artists to sign up and bring their treasures here, right?
The applications are closed now, and okay. We are still getting kind of our final number in. I believe on Thursday we go through a final review, but we've had a sneak peek of who's applied so far, and wow, there's really, really incredible stuff. We were able to retain 3/4 of the artists that came last year, and that's a very, very high percentage.
Yes, it is.
So they had a really good experience. They were selling art, people were buying it, and you know, that's an important part of you know how it works and keeping the artist economy going. So, but yeah, it's a lot more than just art. So music is a really big part of it, and you know, I can speak to the local music scene in Trinidad. I'm a huge music fan and advocate, and that's also part of the reason why I moved to Colorado, because there's, you know, venues like Red Rocks and just so many incredible other ones throughout the state that you might know about. But Trinidad itself has got some really, really impressive local artists, and there's quite a few more that are touring through all the time. So just about 7 days a week, you're able to go see live music in Trinidad for a town that size is really impressive. And it's really high quality too.
It's high quality. We do have a big, if it's a radar screen, we're a big blip in music on the radar screen. You should see it. If it's a map pen, we got one of those big pens. We really do matter in the music scene, and the music scene and the art scene and the creative scene is just one incredible pot of stone soup. The great stuff come from. So I really love where that is. And again, here's the thing. If you come to Trinidad for this art fest, you may not want to go back home. I mean, I came here, Jason and Keely are here, and it's just it's a very welcoming community that has real, true history, you know? So it has real history. So tell me a little bit about the venue and what's around there, because we want to give shout outs of some of our other locally owned businesses too, because you're going to see some great great entrepreneurs and great business owners here to serve you. So tell us a little bit about the venue and around that area.
Yeah, it's right off the highway in downtown Trinidad on Commercial Street and Sister Blandina Gardens. That's where it was last year as well. Mm-hmm. We will be expanding it, and we might have so many artists that some of them are going to be, starting to outgrow the venue just after one year, which is really incredible. And just because we had so much interest and returning artists, and we're going to be expanding to inside Sister Blandina and probably a little bit outside of there. We're going to have food trucks lined up.
Nice.
We're going to have activities for kids. And speaking on that live music, it's going to be start to finish Saturday and Sunday. So you can come and enjoy a lot of Trinidad's finest musicians as well as artists. And yeah, it's going to be, you know, nonstop from, you know, 10 to 6 Saturday and 10 to 4 on Sunday. There'll be, you know, lots of other activities going on. We're going to have some great food trucks and things outside, and it's going to be a really nice event.
Well, and where that is, I mean, Sister Blandina, the Chimino group are kind of behind that, and it's a real passion project for that entire team. But it starts open for the public to for the summer. I think June 3rd. I think June 3rd is when that opens up to the public, and it's you can't hardly call it a pocket park because it's just so beautiful. It's some landscape art in and of itself. But right around that area, there'll be food trucks and everything. But right around that area, you're going to be in the hub of Trinidad, bakeries and coffee shops and art galleries and gift shops and great restaurants and incredible places to get beer. I mean, here's the thing. You come in, you start your morning, get here early. You start your morning with, a bagel or a donut and coffee at one of our great places in the morning. You do the art fest all day and partake of that. And you end the day having pizza, wings, and beer with your family and friends at one of our incredible places there listening to the music. I don't think July 15th comes soon enough, quite frankly. I'm not a big art purchaser. I'm a minimalist. I've kind of minimalized. But Mickey and I walked out of there with a bag full of stuff. You know, it just was almost like, darn it, that's so nice. And darn it, I wish I hadn't seen that. You know, let me not see all this good stuff, because it's just the level of talent that we've been able to attract is it's off the chart. It's just really amazing. And it's in a town of 9,000 people. It's kind of where you'd want to live. That's where we live. We live where you'd probably want to live. But just visit and come here and do things. But and like I said, right around the corner there. So you go up the street a little bit. There's some great music at Curtis and Suzanne's place, the Trinidad Lounge.
Absolutely.
You go around the corner to your place there. You head over to Moose's. Gosh, I know the Smokehouse, great barbecue. The Mission at the Bell. I know I'm going to miss people, but that's why you go to localstash.com and you go to Colorado, go to Trinidad, and you'll find all these great places. Grab your card before you come. Tell me a little bit more about, you said something like 75% of the folks, I think you said that, 75% of the folks that were here last year are back this year. That really speaks to me of success. You know, tell me a little more about that.
Yeah, before I get into it, I just wanted to give a shout out to the Chimino group and Phil Long, who were supporters this year as well as last. They're a big part of the reason that Trinidad Art Fest is able to happen, as well as the Trinidad Tourism Department, who through their grant program is helping bring art and tourism to Trinidad. So thank you to both of those
good job.
Sponsors that are super important. Just wanted to make sure that I cover that before I get too excited and go off on a rant.
No, that's well done, because communities like ours and most communities, especially rural communities, we really need benefactors. Like the arts always had benefactors, so that's not really any different. But we really need people that believe in the bigger picture of the creative class economy and what that can do in extractive economies like ours. I don't want to get on a tangent with regards to that, but when you're trying to convert an extractive economy, coal, you know, gas and those things, into something different, and you can look at the space that was the canvas that Trinidad was and our area was, you need incredible people to do the boots on the ground, but you also need supporters and you need people to see the long-term vision. And the second annual Trinidad Art Fest is part of that vision. Starts off with, we want to do these things. Then somebody jumps forward and they start doing these things. And now we're in the second year, and pretty soon we'll be in the 10th annual Trinidad Art Fest going on. And you'll have some of this white hair in your hair from that. So tell me, we're coming down to a little more time, and I want you to cover anything that we haven't covered. I do want to give a shout out to anybody else that really has been in this area, because that's one of the things we want to do. We think our people are local stashes too. Our people are the treasures in a community, not just the stuff and the businesses and the things to do. So I'm okay if you go on a rant a little bit right now.
I think you just you previously mentioned our retention rate for artists, which is incredibly high. And, you know, I can't preach about how fantastic Lee Lopez is. She's involved in a lot of things around town. Fisher's Peak Outfitters is incredible, but she's a world-class artist. And she actually used to travel around and be in these art shows. So she knows the process. She knows how to put on a good art show, which she's proven. And also, she knows what the artists want. And that was something that she saw when she would travel to these art festivals is, you know, they get you in the door and you set up your art in your booth. And then that's kind of it as far as support. So Lee took it a lot of steps further, bringing water to everyone. And a lot of times the artist brings their whole family and they might be able to, you know, sneak away, use the restroom, get some food, you know, or just take a break and, you know, and kind of a long day for them. And something that was set up through all the different volunteers for Trinidad Art Fest. So the volunteers are also a big part. It's not just the board. Yep. A lot of people are there, you know, working just for the good of the community to put on a good festival. And they've set it up so they can go and give, you know, the artist a chance to step away from the booth for a minute. So just in case someone wants to come and buy something, someone's there to make sure that, you know, that can happen. And ask questions about the art and just be able to give them a break for a few minutes, whether they just need to grab a coffee, use the restroom, that kind of stuff. And having cold water, drinks, complimentary food, and not many art festivals do that. So yeah. I think that she's done it right, as well as the board and all the volunteers. And that's why that retention rate is so high. But that love of art, culture and music, which really ties into what Trinidad is and what it's continuing to grow into, is you know, along with the outdoor recreation activities, but the live music and the art scene are really big draws. The local community loves it, and the people that come here to visit want to come and see that, and they want to come and check out the local art galleries on Main and Commercial. You know, they want to check out our local music scene, you know, for what Kurt and Suzanne's bringing over to the Trinidad Lounge and a variety of the different musical events happening and the Trinidad the Saturday market is just about to open up for the summer. There's live music there, so we're really getting known as a live music and art town. So there's a whole lot to see for when people come and stop in Trinidad.
Well, I'll add to that, a quality music community, quality. I mean, you can go to places and say, I mean, I'm not going to be crazy here, but we're getting to like to be a mini Nashville, a mini what Austin used to be. You know what I mean? A mini kind of Memphis, where you go to place and but there's music. Then you get out of there, and we're so walkable. One of the things I really appreciate you said, because good communities have a lot of different legs to their economic stool, and certainly as we're sharing right now, our creative class economy and the people within that community are just warriors. They're just amazing folks, and they're doing an incredible job to lift the community up. But we also have folks in the recreation space. So bring your bike, bring your pack, you know, bring your dog, go hike. You know, if you haven't been to Fisher's Peak State Park, we see it every day. We're blessed by it looking on us every day. But come on down for that. Head over the other side to Raton. Incredible things on the other side of the hill here. Head up the, you know, you take the drive in on the Legends Highway, Highway 12. Like I said, you may not want to go home for a little while. So you may want to come here between the 14th and the 17th. I know when Mickey and I were at the Art Fest, we would come in, we'd hang around a little bit, listen to music. Then we'd go into town. Then we'd come back. We were there all day. And to your point, all the artists in all the booths had smiles. Everybody at the very last hour of the day, people were still energized that were there. Nobody looked kind of weary. And this has been a slog, and they were all fired up and happy and had a great experience. And so I love what Lee does, not just for the art, but for the artist. I think that will help really build a foundation going forward. So if you're an artist and you weren't able to make the list, if you weren't able to get your application in, there will be a third annual Trinidad Art Fest. And so come to this one and check it out and see, you know, see if we're worthy of you, your time, and your talent. So we've got about five.
We did a double in applicants this year.
You did what?
Yeah, we more than doubled in applicants for people that applied, and
Again.
that's something to be proud of right there. That shows that there was a good experience, that you know, because the artists talk to each other, and if it's not good, if people are not buying the art, if they have a bad experience and they're not taken care of, then they're not going to come back. But the retention rate's high, and word is spreading about their friends to Trinidad, you know, far and wide.
Well, so and again, so when you come, incredible places to stay. Our hospitality hotel folks are professionals. They want you to stay and they want you to have a great visit. And so we've got pillows for you. But when then we also have really great Airbnb and short-term rental folks that are offering stays in homes that are from the 1890s, but modernized with all of the conveniences that you want to have. We've got a new hotel, won't be open for this, I don't believe, but we've got the Hilton Garden Hotel opening up right on the Purgatory River. Yes, we have a
It'll be
river
right down the
that runs
street from
through this
Trinidad
town.
Art Fest.
What's that?
It'll be right down the street from Trinidad Art Fest.
Exactly. So there's some great places. Our restaurateurs, they want you to come in. They want you to have a great experience in Trinidad. So I think what will happen when you do come to the second annual Trinidad Art Fest, I think what you're going to do is you're going to maybe bring some friends because we have places for you to stay and we have places, people that want to serve you. But you're also going to want to come back. This may just be your first taste of Trinidad. You'll want to come back to all the other great things we have going on. So that's about that kind of the run of the time. I do want to say something about the Well Hotel and Tap Room is that it's a little different. Downstairs they got music and upstairs they got music. There's a little different when you come in. Tell me a little bit about the self-serve and that kind of thing and the amount of beers and beverages and things you have there because I just think it's cool.
So we have it's known as a self-pour tap room. So essentially you'll come in and you'll get a magical little RFID card where you're then able to go and, you know, pour your own beer, wine, cocktails. And it's really a unique concept that's kind of catching on in popularity, just because you're able to try a lot of different things without having to bug a bartender. You're like, hey, can I try a little sample of this and a sample of that? Instead, you can go around and maybe try some stuff that you might be a little scared to order a whole one of, but if you can, you know, very easily go have a little sip here, a sip there, and then you're only charged for that sip. You're not charged for a whole drink. So it lets you really explore and, you know, find some new creative stuff. And that's really what we try to offer, is the most creative craft drink selection around. And people seem to like it for the most part. But we also keep, you know, domestic bottles, and people really like their shots around Trinidad as well. So we've got a shot bar, and we opened a restaurant in, I think, December or so. So we got some food, and we serve food till about 10 o'clock at night right now. So
Well, you're on corner of
late night.
you're on a corner of Main and Maple, right? Is
We
it
are,
not?
yep.
Yeah, Main and Maple. So you want to do that. Parking's always something when you go to a new town, you want to say, okay, where can I park? We have parking in town, but we have this hidden treasure, this stash of parking of spaces available right underneath the overpass. So as you come into town, you see commercial there. There's about 150, maybe 200 parking spots right underneath the overpass, right near Habaneros. And it's between Habaneros and the park, and you'll see Cy Michaels calls it Fast Food Row, where the McDonald's is. There's a lot of parking right there. And the thing is, it's so easy to just from there get on commercial and go into town, or from there go the other thing, come through Chimino Park to come that way. So we've got parking for you. It may not be right on the street, but we've got so much covered, cool parking for you that cities would love to have that ability. And I just wanted to say that, Jason, because I don't think enough people tell people about that parking, and I don't think enough people know about that
Yeah,
parking
I agree. I know it's something that's being worked on right now, where there is a lot of parking around, but people might not know about it, or it might not be signed as well as it could be, just so people know that it is a public lot and you can park there. And that is something that I think is going to be improved really shortly. And just another thing that I wanted to mention is, you know, just with this like arts and culture and music thing, there's been a lot of interest from the local community about having First Friday, which is a really fantastic event, but having some street closures for that on some of the First Fridays in the summer, and being able to utilize these local parking lots, possibly the trolley, but then you're really able to bounce around all the fantastic galleries on Main Street and go see music here, go see music in Space to Create, go you know, possibly some music in the street, and being able to really enjoy Main Street and all of its beauty without car traffic for just a couple hours. And there's enough parking around if people just know how to get there. And I think that's something that a lot of the community, I believe there's a town hall about it tonight, where they're going to be, you know, discussing this. Because just being able to have these street closures really helps local businesses. It gets people on the ground. It increases, you know, happiness and community and, you know, tax and revenue lodging for the city and helping local businesses. So it's something that I'm personally really excited about. And there's a lot of people really excited about it. So I think that's something that we're going to see come here really shortly for this summer.
Well,
so that
could it's an excellent point, because what we find is when small core downtowns favor pedestrians over cars, the vibe of the downtown increases, the revenue for the businesses increase, exactly. The experience of the resident or the visitor increases. And so having to be the convenience of parking downtown in front of some places and being there for a friend is trumped by the incredibleness of parking outside of the area and being able to enjoy, again, that vibe and be able to walk around different places. So I'm a big proponent of cars, pedestrians over cars, and a big proponent of outdoors. And so outdoor dining, outdoor walking, outdoor, absolutely, those kinds of things. It's really where I hope we continue to try and go to. I know there's a lot of us that advocate that. And so I think we'll get there. And so that's enough of my rant on that. But I really am a big proponent of people over cars. And I'm just always will be. I just find that it benefits everything. If you want more revenue, it does that. If you want more tax revenue, it does that. If you want your business to be happier, it does that. If you want your visitors and citizens to be happy, it does that. Mm-hmm. So it is a total win when you favor car, you know, people over cars. That's the amount of time. I like starting on time and ending on time.
Thank you, Pat.
You are awesome. Great share. Again, if you get a chance, I'll just read this out. And I'll put some stuff in the notes down below the video, wherever you find this. So when? July 15th and 16th, where? Sister Blandina Wellness Gardens, thanks to the Chimino Group and artists and art lovers, you know, music of all arts. So come on down to Trinidad those times, and I think you have a great time.
It is free to attend, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that, but it's free to attend, family-friendly stuff for pretty much everyone. So come on down and see us. It's going to be a great time.
I sure appreciate you, Keely, and the Art Fest board. You guys are doing amazing work. Thanks much.
All right. Thank you, Pat. Have a good one.